What's up, guys? GeoGebra here. So in this video, we're going to draw a square without using the regular polygon tool. And to do this, we need to go to the geometry perspective. So in this video, we're going to use the parallel and perpendicular line tools to construct a square. Now you can easily construct a square using the regular polygon tool. So just choose the regular polygon tool and then click on two points and then just specify the number of vertices. For example, if you want to draw a square, just type 4 and there you have it. But what happens if you don't want to use the regular polygon tool? So this is just for the sake of learning the other tools. Of course, you can use the regular polygon tool if you want. So first, we draw a segment, and then we draw a circle passing through a circle with center A and passing through B. So we will use the center of the circle with center through point. And then click on A and click on B. Next, I think we can drag this to see what happens if we change the size of the circle. Okay. Next, we need a line which is perpendicular to AB but passing through A. So we use a perpendicular line tool and we click on AB and then click on A. Next, we intersect the circle. This will be the third vertex of our square. Next, we draw a line which is parallel to AB but passing through C. So we will use the parallel line tool, click on AB, and then click on C. Next, we again use the parallel line tool to draw a line which is parallel to AC and passing through B. So with the parallel line tool still active, I click on AC, then click on B. And the intersection will be the fourth vertex of my square. So I click this one, this line, and this one so that I can have my fourth vertex. Okay, so what happens if you drag the points? So again, I won't be needing these lines and the circle. So I'll just hide them by right-clicking and selecting Show Object. And then there goes my square. So I'll click on A and click on B and then connect CD and then connect AB. So what happens if I want to rename the points A, B, C, D? I want to rename them to M, N, O, B. So I'll just right click each of them and then select rename. So M and then N, and I'll just click on the OK button and then O and then P. Now what if I want all the points to be blue? I can just click the style bar here and I can change the color of the points. So I want this blue and this one also blue. But then again, that's very hard to distinguish because the blue points by default are those points which we can drag. But this one, point P and point Q, these are not independent points, because they are intersections of the lines, These are they are intersections of lines. That's why you can't move them. Okay, that's it. I hope you are happy with this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it. Please invite your friends to subscribe to our channel, and don't be shy if you want to ask questions. See you.